book of Galatians. Paul made the case, and now we're just going to see what's happening. Galatians chapter 4, verse 1. I'm just going to start at verse 1, but we're going to read all the way through to the 6th verse. Now I say that the heir, as long as he is a child, differeth nothing from a servant, though he be Lord of all, but is under tutors and governors until the time appointed of the Father. Even so we, when we were children, were in bondage under the elements of the world. But when the fullness of time was come, God sent forth his Son, made of a woman, made under the law, to redeem them that were under the law, that we might receive the adoptions of sons. And because ye are sons, God sent forth the Spirit of his Son into your heart, crying, Abba, Father. Wherefore, thou art no more a servant, but a son. And if a son, then an heir of God through Christ. Father in heaven, we thank you for the privilege of standing before your people one more time and sharing the unadulterated word of God. So I ask you right now for preaching power. Hide, O Green, behind the cross and allow your word to go forth with power and clarity that someone may be convinced that Jesus Christ is Lord to the glory of God the Father. So we thank you, we praise you, and we ask it all in Jesus' name and for his sake. Amen.
Amen.
Why we celebrate Christmas? You know, as the commercialism continued to dominate the holiday season, and political correctness chips away at its meaning, we pause today to remind everybody why we celebrate Christmas.
Amen.
You know, there's been a tremendous effort on the part of those who oppose God to remove the Christ from Christmas. You know, it's all right to mention Santa Claus. It's all right. You know, they celebrate the Grinch. You know, I was listening to some sportscasters the other day, and they were just talking to each other, and that somebody, they were asking, what was their favorite holiday movie? And they come up with stuff like Jingle All the Way and Elf and, you know, just various movies. The Christmas Vacation movie with the Griswolds. Now, me personally, my favorite is It's a Wonderful Life, but I didn't hear nobody say that one. But, you know, we have these images in our culture emphasize the commercialism of Christmas. They made it an opportunity for beginning from the day after Thanksgiving. They call it Black Friday. That's the day when a lot of the retailers go into the black. That's, you don't make money on Black Friday, you're probably going to lose money for the year. And that's just kind of how it works. Finished Black Friday with Cyber Monday. And then they come up with all kinds of ways to get you to spend your money. The holiday season, the Christmas season, Jesus has been removed. Here is an afterthought. I remember many years ago, I was watching this, the Rugrats Christmas movie. This was back when my children were small. And the kids on the Rugrats, they were mentioning holidays like Kwanzaa and Hanukkah and winter solstice. Christmas wasn't even mentioned as part of the holiday tradition. Many businesses refuse to acknowledge Christmas in its advertising for fear of offending that minority that would be that detests Jesus. So why not celebrate the most important event, the resurrection, the most important event in the history of mankind? Why not celebrate Christmas? Why not celebrate the Christ of Christmas?
Yes.
Now, in doing this today, our assignment is to paint this picture of why it is important to celebrate Christmas and remember that Jesus is the reason for the season.
Amen.
And we're going to borrow from the the journalistic rubric. You know, the journalists, they use, when they write an article, they use this rubric: who, what, when, where, why. If you, every journalist, think about that as they write in their column. Well, we're going to use that same rubric as we make the case for why we celebrate Christmas. The Apostle Paul was not thinking about a holiday that we call Christmas when he wrote this letter to the Galatians. But as we apply this, we're going to see that he has actually made the case for us. So the first of the rubric, who?